Okay, that's the Wye Championships today, running a bit late. The clocks went back. We had an extra hour in bed, didn't we? Anyway. Everyone's drawing. Let's see where we're drawing today. It's a big match. It's all down to the draw. So,
Oh, my worms, yeah. I just paid him, so. All right, thanks so much. There you go.
I'm trying to get out the bottom, so we put it back in.
I might need it today as well, Belmont, with a with a birch. Oh, it is. Right, train time for breakfast. Yeah, what are you drawing?
What's that going to be like? 107, 205.
Oh, bloody hell. Hell of a walk.
Is it?
Yeah. Oh, is it? It might be then.
Oh, I don't know.
You'd have to look at the map, see where it is. Here we are. So I've got to look at the map as well.
Where is the map?
Okay, lads. So I've drawn peg 24, which is about permanent peg 20 on Belmont. Not the best peg, to be honest, but then, you know, the river's coming up, it's coloured. Those out-of-town pegs might be washed away today, you know, they might be not so good. So, at least I'm in sort of an area where maybe there are some fish. Not babble, I've been told. The bleak on the inside, you know, perch days maybe. But as I say, it is coloured. I just had a look at the water now. So, let's get to the peg, let's have a look at it, and I'll decide then. It's a bit of a walk from the pump house, but there we are. I'll see you up there then. Okay, here we are. Permanent peg 20 on the post there, 20, and it's actually 24 in the match. So there's a sawdust. Got some sawdust. Put my peg number on. There you go. Right, now I'm not sure about this bank. I don't know if there's a ledge on there, maybe. Gonna have a look now, just gotta be careful I don't bloody fall in again. Right, looking at it, water definitely coming up. This is going through a bit of colour. Don't know, it's a bit too boily for bleak, I think. Well, you never know, I said one rig up for it. Probably looking for perch or something down the side, roach maybe, dace, who knows. Probably a feeder job. Probably pushing through a bit too hard going across there. Because I know this is a chub area. Well, those pegs below, 22 and 24. I'm just one above it. So, you never know why it's a funny old place. Sometimes there's fish here, sometimes there's not. Okay, let's tackle up then. Okay, the match has started. Just had a couple of roach and a couple of dace on the feeder. It's gone off a little bit at the moment. I put a worm on now and I just had a couple of perch. But it's a bit slow. I might go back on the maggot again. So I'm using a block end. I'm on a big hook, I'm on a size 10 hook, double maggot. No, I'm going to put a double maggot on. But I am getting pestered by bleak. And the thing is, do I go for bleak? I mean, the match is about 3/4 an hour in. If I'm going to go for them, I should stand on them now, but you know. First of all, a bit longer on this. See what happens. Yeah, So you can get bleak on the feeder now. That's fine.
I don't really want to go for bleak, it's not a team.
Getting knocks all the time, yeah. You keep them coming and be all right. Well, I'm about three rod lengths out, two rod lengths out, so I'm not up very far at all. perch, isn't he? I did put a few balls in, we chopped worm in, so that's supposed to probably attracted them, yeah? Leak on the feeder. Any nuisance? Ladded out then. I got Dave Adel above me, and he's out in the middle. He's probably going for Babel or Chubb or something. I don't know if he's had any. Worm on, I think. And the worm. I don't get it. I couldn't lift that up as it was spiking me then. But it was about a pound, that one. It's like about 30 bleak. Very tempted for some more chopped worm in, but I don't know. I'm gonna overfeed it. Fish grabbing the worm. Put a bit more caster in, I think. Clouds coming over again. If it starts raining, I'll have to turn the camera off because I'll get away. Room got chopped in half then. You probably can't see a lot here, what's going on, but as I say, it's the quandary now, what to do, you know, go for bleak or, you know, they have some big perch here by the look of it. Thank you.
sign off for the moment. I'll come back a little bit later when it clears up.
Okay, right. It's halfway through the match now. I've had about 7 or 8 perch. I've had a couple of roach and dace. I had a little go for the bleak, only because it's dried up on the feeder. So I might go back on the bleak in a minute. But the sun's out now. That's good. One good thing, because it was absolutely belting down just now. Right, okay. Yeah, so I'm going to go on the worm again. Give it 10 minutes, I haven't had a bite yet, so I might go back on a maggot in a minute, see what happens. I don't know whether this water's actually stopped rising though. Still a bit coloured, mine. Still a bit coloured. There's bleak is still there. Going out a little bit further on the feeder at the moment. There's a bite then. Yeah, is that? That he leaves. No, it don't looks like it's they're not queuing up those perch, you know, they just getting the odd ones, like, you know. So I'll go back on the maggot. Probably get bleaked out, so we'll see. Double maggot. Yeah, straight away look. What do I do? Do I go for them or not? Yeah, well, I think I might as well just go for the bleak. Let's have a go check for Babel in the middle. Oh dear. Let's have a go for a break, because for the time being. Oh, they're too small. Much too small. Yeah, they're very small sizes. The kippers I was getting last the other match, and I fell in. Yeah, I think this is a young man's game, this bleaking. You know, to be able to count him. I mean, if you can average about 6 a minute, you know, you should do a good weight. Counting them, I mean, hard work. Yeah, I'll have to go for perch again in a minute. You know, underneath them all. shook myself then. That hurt. Wind's picking up a bit. First kip that I've had, dropped back in the water. Getting back on the feed at the moment, see what happens. Feeding, hoping that they would go away. They're not. In fact, coming to the splash of the float now. trouble is they're very small, these fish. If I look in them now, look, so many there. Have a little go on the feeder again because I'm getting away fast with these really. I mean, as I said, if it's a T-Max, then you know I keep going for them, but if it's a, you know, if there's a chance of any bigger fish around, I think I'd rather fish for them, I think. Comes a point when the skin is there's hardly any skin left. Consequently, it's coming off. Okay, let's have a go on the worm now. See if there's any perch. Can't see me getting anywhere with this lease anyway. Oh, I've had enough of them. Oh, let's have a go. Let's see if we can eat decent fish. That was a small taste then. The discs are there, they're underneath them. But whether I get a better weight with them, I don't know. Need a couple of bonus perch, I think. Or roach. I'll find it in a few days now. Stopped introducing the ground bait and I just loose feed in the block end. Brooks.
yeah, there. Thought I got away with him then. Deke moved in now, so I think I'll have a go on the corn. Put a bit of corn on, I think. A worm on first, see what happens. Big worm.
missed the bite on the worm there. Try the corn out. I had a bite on it. Go back on the worm, I think. Okay, I'll let you know if anything happens. Okay, the match is over. What can I say? Right, apparently Dave Adler above me's had a few barbel, and he's had a few barbel below me. Whether I got enough small fish to beat them that, but I don't know. But in hindsight, if I'd gone for Bleak on, which I could have had £20, which would have probably been enough for the section. But because it's an open, you know, you really think to yourself, well, you know, you've got to go for something looking for a bit bigger, haven't you, than, you know, the average £20-30. But there you are. I suppose you make your decisions and that's it, I suppose. But there you are. Anyway, I've enjoyed my day. It's, you know, it's been raining on and off. It stopped now at the moment, nice and sunny. Sod's low, and it always, when the match finishes, it, the weather turns out nice. So anyway, so we'll see what we got now for the weigh-in. The steward's just come along, and we said, you know, it's going to be pretty close between a few anglers along here, you know, for the section. So anyway, okay, see you in a bit then. Okay, they're just underway in now. Dave Harrell with a few barb, a couple of barb and things. You okay?
Hey,
mate.
Alright.
Alright.
He's got his way now.
Oh. What do you have?
13.
13?
Yeah.
Quiet. Oh, I don't know, mate. Not a lot, really. Huh? Not a lot. I mean, I could have gone for Bleak and had £20, I think. That would have been, you know.
What did Kevin have?
I don't know. Below me? I don't know. Oh.
Yes, Bleak King. 54 hours.
Back up
an hour.
Do you
want to make sure? Why?
Well, what?
Because I was looking at my watch and my box and not my iPhone.
Yeah, we're good to go.
Well, I did win my section with
£19.6. Did you? Where have you been?
12.
Oh.
Have you got one?
Perch again?
Three perch, two roach.
Yeah. And then Bleak.
Well, you're attacking a lobworm. You can get a lobworm from.
Yeah.
Somebody gets a pick. 16.2.
How much? 16.2.
16.2. Okay, there you go, £26, so that's won the section. Well, actually, it's the best weight along here at the moment. So, yeah, it's a funny game, isn't it? You know, I've had a couple of disappointments lately, like, and then today I seem to, you know, do the right things and have to win the section. I don't think it'll get in the main frame because I've heard there's a 47 and there's a couple of others down there, you know, down in the tennis courts. And I expect out of town there'll be have a few weights as well. So, but anyway, I'm happy. Section win, that's all I can do. So I'll go back and collect my money. See you later.
With Brainton. Brainton A, pegs 1 to 5, with a weight of £17.1, is Dave Roberts. Moving on to Brainton B, with a weight of £24 exactly, is Doug Forshew.
Doug Forshew.
Okay.
Well done, Doug.
Brainton C, with a weight of £46. No, forget that one. Start again. Brainton C, with a weight of £27.6, was Andy Murphy. Okay. Belmont 1A, with a weight of £19.6, is Kevin Dix.
Kev. Right, he's milking it, he is milking it.
Right, moving on to Belmont 1B with a weight of 26 pounds exactly. Clive Branson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Belmont 1C with a weight of 16 pounds 1 is Tony Burke.
You picked up 2 weeks in a row.
That's a bit solid. Right. Moving on to Belmont 2. Belmont 2A with a weight of £23.9. Terry Parrott. Oh! Moving on to Belmont 2B with a weight of £27.1. Alex Graham.
You always does well on your figures, huh?
Right, okay, Belmont 2C with a weight of £25 exactly was Simon Deakin.
Well done, Big Sam. That's what you want
to do. Right, Belmont 2D.
Not hard, is it?
With a weight of £33 exactly, Jim Wilson. Okay, Belmont 3A with a weight of £42.14, Adrian Whittle. Yay.
Well done,
Belmont 3B with a weight of £38.14. Chris Parr.
Chris the lad, he done well.
Okay, Belmont 3C with a weight of £36.12, Adrian Griffin.
Yeah. Yeah, that was on the meat.
Denzel!
Hey! Blah, blah, blah. Yeah.
Okay, moving on to the tennis court. With a weight of £39, 8 ounces, Ian Hingley. Bart Chimay. With a weight of £19, 14, Phil Williams. Oh, dear.
Well done, young man.
Okay, Barton B, with a weight of £23.8, Martin Ward.
C with a weight of
£45.14, Brian Rigby.
Several pieces.
Okay.
9B
with a weight of £19.12, Kev Ellaby.
Well,
C with a weight of £26.12, Chris Smith. Okay, Field Farm A with a weight of £29.12, Simon Garbutt. Field Farm B with a weight of £26.12, Martin Challenger. Trousers now. Moving on to promo A with a weight of £25.02. Winner is Craig Curtis. Okay, promo B. Vanuatu B with a weight of £37.02 is Dave Britton. And right, Home Lacey A with a weight of £44.03, Phil Amos. And final section, win with a weight of £21 exactly, Stuart Hartford.
Well, Tammy picked up some money.
Right, moving on to the overalls. Six overall with a weight of £55.06. Nope, I beg your pardon. Right, six overall, all's in reverse order. That's the first time I've done that. With a weight of £46 exactly from Brayton C. is Mick Gramlich. Well done. Fifth overall, with a weight of £47.02 from the tennis courts, Ben Rendell. Fourth overall, with a weight of £49 exactly, from Ine A, is Tony Avery. Well, third overall today with a weight of £50.06 from Belmont 3 D is Paul Bick. Okay, runner up today with a weight of £51.12.
Well, she's done it now.
I can read. I wasn't. I didn't say 55 either. £51.12 from Belmont 3C, Chris Stevens. And seeing as you all know who the winner is, I shouldn't bother announcing it. Right, okay. So, 2022 wide champion from Belmont 2B with a weight of £55.06, James Robbins.
Oblique.